Okay, day 336. I just found out that I have a Dell power supply for my HP laptop and it doesn't have as much power. That's why I'm losing power. I don't know where the switch happened. I think this started after I filed the lawsuit, the reconsideration lawsuit on Friday. So you can check the tape. But anyway, I'm not going to waste any more time with that. I've tried to keep away from drugs as long as I could with the depleted uranium, the white phosphorus weapons, using these cars as vehicles. But eventually, at some point, you have to bring up the drugs going the other way for a wand gate. So I'm going to stay away from that. But eventually, I'm just warning everyone there's going to be a drug piece to this. This CDW, the St. Valentine's Day embezzlement, kicks things off in February. We don't know if Tulsi Gabbard resigns a fortnight later. We do know that in May 12th, there's this emergency meeting. It turns out the Rayburn Room is actually in the Capitol. So when Nancy Pelosi was pulling it together, she wasn't in the Rayburn office building, which is next to the Capitol. She was actually in the Capitol. So she was summoning everyone and Imran to that room. So this is obviously very important. Now, I would say that the meetings around this investigation around the end of February are the House IG Inspector General type activity. These are going to be more DNC related just because of the timing. 2 weeks later, after that emergency meeting, is when the DNC leaks go out with the finance. Now, the financial emails, the first round of Debbie Wasserman Schultz. It could be that people are discovering the Act Blue thing at this time in February that kicks off all this stuff. There's two different investigations. One is the CDW embezzlement, the phone doping, and then the other one is the Act Blue stuff. It could be, but just timing wise, just go by proximity analysis, you would have Tulsi Gabbard quitting here at the end of February because she finds out about this initial Inspector General report. Could be wrong. Could be wrong. Could be the DNC. People were complaining about the Act Blues and DNC way back here. Could be the CDW thing came up here later on and that caused the emergency meeting. I just think when you steal congressmen's money, that's a much bigger deal than if you dope their phones. They don't really know that you're doping their phones, but they know when you're stealing their money. They know when you're stealing your money. And that is going to give people, if that is going to give people the impetus to leak. So it's just, a little bit of logical thinking, but we'll see. Again, this seems to be the operations headquarters for all the phone doping and IT type stuff, and also a nice place for kind of like a command center. It's a very big house, right? So, but the GSA, we've learned, we know that we bought a lot of this stuff on GSA, but there may be these other locations are satellite locations for different operations. Fort Belvoir, which is going to be more the security for the Coast Guard security stuff, really selling Coast Guard is not just one of them, it's just one of the agencies. Lots of DOD agencies in the counter drug program, and that is going to be receiving all the goods. So there's going to be somebody who's doing the cameras, the low light cameras, those special Toshiba low light cameras over at the spray.